thought we should really talk about how do you visit colleges at a crazy time like this when universities are closed. I don't know about you, but I'm getting pretty tired of everything being so different. And one of the things that's very, very different for us right now is how do you visit colleges and how do you demonstrate interest in a college and get the information that you need when you can't actually go to the campus. So I thought I've been brainstorming some ideas with my Goal Care Club members on how to visit and how to get this useful information and how to demonstrate interest when classes are canceled and you can't step foot on the campus. So here's my quick list that I was going to share with you on how do you handle these kinds of things during a global pandemic. Who would have thought we would ever talk about this, right? So idea number one, the student and the parent can engage with colleges on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and other social media. The students can ask them questions, particularly on Instagram and Facebook. Sometimes those are staffed now with admission people who are well-versed in how to answer. Students and parents both can be liking, sharing, commenting on their social media posts. You can contact them in person by email. You can visit their website regularly. You can check for pandemic updates, information on their blog or their other ways of sharing information with you so that you know what is going on and when they're going to allow visits again. And when you're doing all these things, allow cookies, you know, allow cookies, not the chocolate chip kind, but the cookies that are on websites, because then they can see if your computer has been visiting their website. Now, always visit the campus, even if it is a virtual tour. And what that means is you're trying to arrange an online appointment. You're trying to arrange a time to meet with an admissions officer. So you call the admissions office. Now, you don't want to be bugging them. You're trying to get just a normal amount of information from them and also doing research online as well. When you're doing that, ask if you can attend one of their online classes, because classes are all online now. That's going to really help you to understand how well do they do teaching students online if you can't go to campus next year, say. So attend any visits, online lectures that you can with the faculty. And when you're all done with those visits and classroom participation, make sure you send a thank you note to each of the persons that you've interacted with. You can also demonstrate interest after that initial visit, once you've gotten to know them better. You can have a Skype interview with faculty, department heads, something that your student is interested in. You can list them as one of your top colleges when you take the SAT or the ACT so that they know you're proclaiming to the world that they are your top choices. You can send them test scores even if they're not required. Especially helpful when you're sending those test scores first, because the first four test scores are free. And if they know that you're sure you're going to send them test scores because they're free, they're more likely to know that you appreciate them. You can contact the faith groups on campus to see if you can find a church family for your student to attend and interact with them. Finding that church home can make a difference. You can read a summary of all of their facts and data on a reference book and then follow up with your admission counselor on any questions that you have. You definitely want to carefully read and meet their admission policy, their admission requirements, procedures that they have. Read and comply with their homeschool admission policy if they do have one. Make sure that you get great letters of recommendation and send those to the colleges as well, even if it's optional. Those letters of recommendation do not come from you as the parent. They go directly from the recommender to the college that you're applying to. At some colleges, you can even take online classes at the university when you're in high school. That's another thing. Another thing you can do is to apply the very first day that their applications are open. So you find out when's the first day you can apply as a senior and you apply that day. You can email your advisor to request an application. You can even say when you're doing that online virtual visit, do you waive application fees if you have taken a virtual tour? You can also be very explicit with them and say, you are the first choice college on my list. You know, be really upfront about it. You can try to use the college's own application form if they have one. It's easier to demonstrate interest than it is on the Common App or the Coalition App, where it's a little harder to demonstrate interest. Write all colleges' application essays, even the ones that are optional. You want to make sure that you give them every optional piece of information that they might request. And then ask your college contact to comment on your student paper or something like that. So if you've sent them your essay, you can just say, what did you think about it? That sort of thing. Whenever you're visiting online, keep one thing in mind. This is a place where your student is going to be living and learning for 4 years. So you want them to feel at home there. So when it is possible and you can visit, make sure that you visit in person before sending them there to live for 4 years, so you know whether it's a good choice. Well, that was quick. I hope that really explains things. Have fun visiting colleges virtually from the comfort of your own home. Take care.